Assalamu alaikum. We begin with Allah's name, the most gracious, the most merciful. And may Allah's blessings and peace be upon His Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wassalam. In the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the word colors in the plural in several places. And likewise, we find mentioned several colors. This is well worthy of more research. However, what has already been discovered is truly amazing. The word colors, in the plural, has various forms, all of which are one word, such as the word its colors, in Arabic, alwanu, or your colors, in Arabic, alwanukum. The word colors was repeated throughout the Quran a total of 7 times. So why specifically 7 times? Amazingly, this matches the colors of the light spectrum, or what is called the visual spectrum, and they are 7 colors. This is why rainbows are 7 colors: red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, and violet. But could this be a coincidence? To answer this, we go and find the first verse in the Quran that mentions colors in the plural. Looking at this verse, we are shocked to find that the word colors in this verse is both the 7th word counting from the start of the verse and the 7th word counting from the end of the verse. This is stunningly beautiful mathematical harmony. Colors of the visual spectrum are 7. Colors in the plural in the Quran are 7. And the first mention of colors in plural is the 7th word of the verse, regardless of which direction one starts counting from. But as you surely suspect, it does not end here. The mathematical perfection continues, and we find that the total letters in this verse are 49. So what about it? As you may have noticed, 49 equals 7 times 7. Subhanallah. Yet this is the Quran, and the miraculous is endless. Looking even closer, we find that the verse number is 13, and it has a total of 13 words. So what relationship is being pointed out between 13 and 7? We know that 7 times 13 equals 91. But what is 91? We are shocked to realize that the total sum of the verse numbers from the start of the chapter up to this verse is exactly 91. The mathematical code is stunning. Furthermore, the total number of words from the start of the chapter up to and including this verse is 147. This is equal to 7 times 7 times 3. And we have already seen how 7 is the total mentions of the word colors in the Quran, and that there are 7 colors in the visual spectrum. But what about this 3? Amazingly, 3 is the total number of primary colors, i.e. red, yellow, and blue, from which we can get the rest of the colors. Yet the amazing code is endless. Before moving on with colors, let's continue looking at this verse, i.e. ayah. Its key word, colors, is in the exact center, with 6 words to its right and 6 words to its left. At this point, I'll add my own observation to the findings of others, which is that white is when all colors are showing together, while black is when none of the colors are reflected. We leave black for later, but we have what is clearly the key color verse here, which is the first mention of colors in the Quran. So we add 6 plus 6 for 12, and amazingly, when we check the mentions of white in the Quran, they are exactly 12 times. Yet there still remains the question of why is the first mention of colors, the seventh word counting from either end, centered between two sixes. Is there more to these seven and six? What is this code for? Amazingly, we find that while, as already mentioned, colors was mentioned in total seven times, these seven mentions were in six verses. So total verses which mention colors is six. The mathematical harmony is endless. So six has been highlighted even individually and as two sixes. But is there more to this? We remember that it is verse 13 and had 13 words, and its keyword was centered between two sixes. And suddenly we are stunned to realize that 13 is a prime number, and its order among prime numbers is 6. The mathematical code is amazing. But all of this means we need to do something important. Surely we need to look at the 6 verses which mentioned colors, and when we do, we find some striking findings. The sum total of the numbers of these verses equals 180, which is 66 plus 14, with 14 being the total number of chapters in the Quran. Let's focus then on the chapters they appeared in. The sum total of their chapter numbers equals 120, which is 6 plus 14, i.e. total chapters in the Quran and total verses which contain the word colors. What is even more stunning is that 120 is also the total number of words in these 6 verses, which again is 6 plus 14, with 14 equaling the chapters of the Quran and 6 the number of verses which mentioned colors. The mathematical harmony is endless. We also notice that out of the entire alphabet, only one letter did not appear in all 6 of these verses, and it is the letter Gha or Ghayn. So, is there a numerical highlight here? The Hijai alphabetic order of Gha or Ghayn is 17. So what does that have to do with colors? By now, in this series, it is evident to you how prime numbers are a key in Quran mathematics, and amazingly, 17 is a prime number. Its order among prime numbers is 7. Of course, 7 is equal to the mentions of the plural of colors and the number of colors in the visual spectrum, and the first mention of colors is the seventh word in the verse. But does it end here? We have looked at the sum total of the order of letters not mentioned in these 6 colors verses. And since it was just one letter, that was easy. But how about the sum total of the alphabetic order of the letters that were mentioned, i.e. the rest of the alphabet, excluding the Ghayn? Their alphabetic order sum total is 389. So what about it? The letter Ghayn was 17, which was a prime number, and its order was 7. Here again, we see that 389 is also a prime number. So we check its order among prime numbers, and shockingly, it is 77. Like everything else we have mentioned, this is beyond human capacity. First mention of colors is seventh word from the start and seventh word from the end. And all verses containing the word colors have one letter not mentioned, which has an alphabetic order in the prime numbers of which is 7. And all the letters mentioned have an alphabetic order, sum total, which is also a prime number, and its order is 77. Can words really do justice to this amazing mathematical symphony? Yet brace yourself for what comes next. All mentions of colors were in only 4 chapters. When we multiply 77 times 4, we get 308. So what is this, you ask? 308 is the sum total of all verses of the only four chapters which mentioned colors. Please let me rephrase this. When we add the total verses of all four surahs, i.e. chapters, that did mention colors, we get exactly 308. This is mind-blowing and simply impossible. Then to top it all off, those who use modern grammar rules also add that the letters of the word colors in Arabic have a letter alphabetic order sum, the total of which is 77. It is simply breathtaking. But just when you think it cannot get even more incredible, we are reminded that this is the Quran and the miraculous is endless. So consider this. We saw earlier how 114, which is the total chapters in the Quran and the main key in Quran mathematics, played a role in the code of these six verses collectively. Keep this in mind and think about this. The mentions of colors, the plural form, in the Quran was in only six verses of four chapters. In all of these six verses together, we find that only one letter repeated in these verses six times, and it was the letter Tha. So, is there a letter that repeated only four times? We find that the only letter which repeated in all of these verses only four times is the letter Vad, i.e. Va. So, six verses and four chapters, and these are the letters which represent those numbers by matching them inside the six verses. Now realize this mind-blowing discovery. The total appearances of the letter Tha in all four of the chapters which mention colors is 114. This is stunning, but how can we prove it's not by accident? Take a breath and bear witness. The total mentions of the letter Dhad in all four of these chapters is also exactly 114. Subhanallah. Subhanallah, this is breathtakingly impossible. It is beyond human capacity. Go ahead and check it. If you are like me, you will have to watch this video several times because it is so incredible, it does take a while to digest. For now, however, we must move on, and what follows is more direct and clear, but also stunning. As for the color green, we are told in the Quran and the Prophet's teachings that the people of Jannah, i.e. paradise, will be dressed with green clothes, and the dominant color in paradise is the color green. So it is directly connected to paradise. Then when we count how many times the color green is mentioned throughout the Quran, it is 8 times. But why 8? This miraculously matches the 8 doors of paradise. This dictates that we should dig deeper in this direction. Knowing that hell, Jahannam, is black, as next will be addressed, and has 7 doors, as stated in the Quran, how many times do you think the color black is mentioned in the Quran? As you probably guessed, the color black, in its various forms, is mentioned in the Quran exactly 7 times. Subhanallah. This is again amazing. How can both green and black perfectly match their mentions in the Quran with the doors, i.e. gates, of paradise and hell, which are directly related to those colors? Furthermore, when an object absorbs all the 7 colors, we get black. And this is again another match for black being mentioned 7 times. Yet, shortly we will see what is even more shocking. But first, I wish to add this bonus segment. Here is an interesting observation related to our topic, and it was highlighted by several, including Abdeddaim al-Kahil. It is about the authentic Sahih Hadith by the Prophet Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام, where he said, "Your ordinary fire is one of 70 parts of the hellfire." Someone asked, "O Allah's Messenger, this ordinary fire would have been sufficient to torture the unbelievers." Allah's Messenger said, "The hellfire has 69 parts more than the ordinary worldly fire. Each part is as hot as this worldly fire." Then we remember that many teachings and the Quran say that the hellfire appears black because of how hot it is, i.e., it is so hot that it turned black. If our ordinary fire, according to most sources, is about 1100 degrees Fahrenheit in the middle of the burning portion, then according to the Prophet Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام, hell is multiplied by 70, which of course is 1100 times 70 equals 77,000 degrees Fahrenheit. The amazing thing is that now we know that indeed at those very high temperatures, a fire or burning object goes beyond blue and becomes black. This is both numerically and scientifically miraculous. This is important to astronomy because while our sun is hot and appears to us as bright white or yellow, hotter stars such as Sirius is so hot at 18,000 degrees Fahrenheit that it glows blue. Then at even greater temperatures, stars become almost invisible to us in space because they become totally black. As stated, a color beyond the range to which our eyes or ordinary telescopes are sensitive. This is why scientists resort to using black body radiation methods to study these unimaginably hot stars. How could the Prophet Muhammad والسلام, know that at those temperatures he specifically described the colors becomes black to our eyes? And hell was specifically mentioned as being black specifically because of how hot it was. Anyway, let's get back to our amazing mathematics and consider this. Hell has 7 gates, called doors in Arabic, and paradise has 8. In Arabic, they are called abwab, i.e. doors or gates, which is the plural form of door. Obviously, their total is 7 plus 8 equals 15. So what about 15? The stunning find is that the word doors in the plural form in the Quran was mentioned exactly 15 times. This again is shocking. How can we know through the Quran and the Prophet's والسلام, teachings that hell and the paradise have a total of 15 doors? And when we count all mentions of the word doors in the Quran, they are exactly 15. The mathematical harmony is truly amazing. So why stop here? Keeping in mind that hell has 7 gates and paradise has 8, we take all 15 verses which mention doors in their order of appearance in the Quran. Shockingly, the 7th verse in this group says, "So enter the doors of hell, eternally abiding therein." Then odious, indeed, is the lodging of those who are arrogant. So hell has 7 doors, and the 7th verse in this order is specifically about how the evildoers will enter the gates of hell. The perfect harmony is endless. So what about the 8th verse in the order? Again, we are shocked to see that the 8th verse says, "Eden, paradise, everlasting gardens, whose doors, i.e. gates, will be open for them." So paradise has 8 doors, and the 8th verse in this list of verses which contain the word doors is about how the doors of paradise will be open for the righteous believers. keep in mind that not all of these verses mention hell or paradise. In fact, 8 of them mention neither at all. Subhanallah, the Quran's mathematical code is truly amazing. It is impossibly enough for doors of paradise to match mentions of green, but to remove all doubt, black mentions also perfectly match the doors of hell. This is impossibly enough, but then we also find that doors are perfectly matching the mentions of both together. And just in case anyone has doubts, not only are colors 7 and their mentions in the Quran 7 and their verse revolves around 7, but it becomes completely beyond human capacity when we review what we had already mentioned. Colors are mentioned in 6 verses within 4 chapters, and the only 2 letters that appeared, one letter 4 times and the other 6 times in the color verses, each appeared exactly 114 times in those 4 chapters. This is beyond human capacity. How can this math uncover the key 77? And then when we multiply it by the number of chapters we are using, we get exactly the sum total of all verses in these 4 chapters. It is the Quran, the book of the all-knowing creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who said, "And say, praise be to Allah. He will show you his signs, and you will recognize them, and your Lord is not unaware of what you do." Please support this channel and register at binimad.com, where you will soon be able to freely download my book, Quran Math Miracles, and other material. But importantly, because it is very helpful, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe, share it with your friends, and until next time, Assalamu alaikum.